was telling this man that he would have to marry Ruth, and that the child that came from that union would then actually be Malin's child and would inherit the land that he was going to buy. And for whatever reason, the man didn't want to do that. But Boaz was willing. Our Heavenly Father sent His Son to this earth because He was willing for our salvation. Boaz is willing to unselfishly marry me, have a child who would then inherit the land that he's going to buy. Verse 8, therefore the close relative said to Boaz, buy it for yourself. So he took off his sandals, and Boaz said to the elders and all the people, you are witnesses this day that I have bought all that was Elimelech and all that was Chilion and Malon from the hand of Naomi. Moreover, it's Ruth the Moabitess, the widow of Malon, I have acquired as my wife to perpetuate the name of the dead to his inheritance, that the name of the dead may not be cut off from among his brethren and from his position at the gate. You are witnesses this night. And all the people who are at the gate and the elders said, we are witnesses. The Lord make the woman who has come into your house like Rachel and Leah, the two who built the house of Israel. And may you prosper in Ephrathah and be famous in Bethlehem. May your house be like the house of Perez and Tamar, border of Judah, because of the offspring which the Lord will give you from this young woman. It's interesting that the people praise Ruth so. She's a Moabitess. Just a few short years before, Moab was hiring Balaam to curse Israel. But Ruth saw in Naomi a picture of God and she wanted more of it. So she was willing to leave her land of birth and come live with Naomi. And when they were coming there, it looked like it would be a very humble existence. They were two poor widows. And yet God blessed them greatly, didn't He? Verse 13, so Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife. And he went into her, and the Lord gave her conception, and she bore a son. Then the women said to Naomi, blessed be the Lord, who has not left you this day without a close relative, and may his name be famous in Israel, and may he be to you a restorer of life and a nourisher in your old age. But your daughter-in-law, who loves you, Ruth better than seven sons that has borne him. Then Naomi took the child and laid him on her bosom and became a nurse to him. Also the neighbor women gave him a name, saying, there is a son born to Naomi, and they called his name Obed. He is the father of Jesse, the father of David. Now this is the genealogy of Perez. Perez begot Hezron. Hezron begot Ram. Ram begot Abinadab. Abinadab begot Nashon. Nashon begot Salmon. And Salmon begot Boaz. And Boaz begot Obed. Obed begot Jesse begot David. You go to Matthew, you'll find just beyond you there. And Luke, the genealogy of our Savior. I hope, as we consider a small book this morning, that you appreciate more how much our Heavenly Father loves each one of you. He loves us tenderly, just like Boaz loved Ruth. We need to always remember that. Show God. our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for everything that you've done for us, for your loving kindness and steadfastness toward each one of us. And I pray that each one this morning will go from this place comforted in their mind that you are looking after each one of us for our best interests. And that we can trust you to guide us. So you come again, we pray in Jesus' name.